We did move from the other hotel to here, the Palau Pacific Resort, site of an important naval airbase during the Japanese occupation of the Palau Islands.
This historic site was built in 1934 by South Seas Development Company, when the first commercial air route was anticipated. Then, during World War II, the Japanese used this for military purposes. The small hill is where the control tower and associated small buildings were. This base had unlimited takeoff and landing areas along Kobosong Harbor and also served as repair base. Majority of the structures on this island were military in nature during the Japanese occupation of Palau. And then on March 30th, 1944, Task Force 58 pulled up here and pasted this place, destroyed all of the air bases, blew up most of the shipping in the harbor and around the various islands, and pretty much put this place out of action. However, they still decided that they needed to take Palau, and that island was invaded a few months later.
Here you can see all the way across one of the seaplane ramps, and they use them for water sport activities at the hotels now. And all of this concrete down under here was part of the seaplane base apron over here. Grass has grown over it, but you can't hide it. This is pretty worn away here. This is exposing the rebar that was used to build the ramp. Up here in the apron area, you can still see some of the old airplane tie-downs have survived and are still here in the concrete, arranged at the proper distance, I believe, to have tied down their seaplanes. And across there, the other ramp. So this is quite a large base here. It's a very well-protected lagoon, perfect place for seaplane operations.
Some of this area was chewed up pretty well, maybe storms and time, and also it could have been bombs from the attacking Navy aircraft.
This could easily be a bomb-damaged area here. There's a big hole, just all chewed up.
You can actually see these bomb craters on the ramp in this aerial damage assessment photo from Operation Stalemate I.